These views were raised by stakeholders during the regional high-level dialogue on advancing local vaccine manufacturing and access in Africa held in Kampala. They noted that lack of political will to harness regional pharmaceutical production creates negative competition to local industries. According to Jane Nalunga, the executive director of CIATIN Uganda, developing countries can leverage trade, investment and intellectual property policies to expedite manufacturing of vaccines.
As you know, the COVID pandemic was an eye-opener because we didn't have our own vaccines. We had to depend from outside the country, from developed countries. And you remember, the developed countries even had boosters, second boosters, before we got our own, before they gave us the vaccines. So that was an eye-opener that as Africa, we need to manufacture our own medicines, our own vaccine.
Dr. Dungu says that although the landscape of drug manufacturing in Uganda has registered a significant growth over the years, from just six manufacturers to now over 27.
We do have a classifications which run up to maturity level 1 up to maturity level 4. However, still, when you look at these maturity levels, you ask yourself, how do we get to them? One of the issues that requires you to invest to arrive at such levels needs capital. For example, you will see that the necessities required to attain these policy requirements need resources that we do not have at the same level playing field as Western companies.
So they can have duty-free building materials or equipment or materials so that they can set up at a cost that is really affordable. We also need to go into the trade laws. Right now, there is need for defragmentation of markets. When you look at the Ugandan market, and then the East African markets and the African market, if you're manufacturing vaccines, you need to look at the African market. Unfortunately, you require to register that drug or get approvals for that vaccine in 55 African countries.
Most of these are limited to solid doses and simple formulation manufacturing. Statistics indicate that Uganda currently imports 99% of vaccines used by its citizens, despite the fact that the sector offers huge investment opportunities to thrive on.